Welcome to PEECS Chemistry. Today we are going to discuss polymers. Polymers are the most important substances of modern chemistry. We are using polymers in our day-to-day life. Even though they are having many adverse effects, there are so many uses for polymers. Let us see some important aspects regarding polymers. What are these polymers? Polymers are also called as macromolecules. The word polymer means many parts. In Greek, poly means many and meros means parts. Thus, polymer means many parts. A polymer is a compound of high molecular mass, that is about 10^3 to 10^7 U, formed by the combination of large number of small molecules. Hence, these polymers can also be called as macromolecules. Macro means big, because they are big molecules. What are these monomers? The small molecules which constitute the repeating units in a polymer are called as monomers. So, what is polymerization? It is a process of formation of polymer from the respective monomers. It is termed as polymerization. For example, let us take the case of polythene. All of you may be familiar with polythene. It is a polymer which is obtained by the polymerization of ethylene. You can see the reaction here. So, ethylene molecule undergoes polymerization to form polythene or polyethylene. Here, ethylene molecules are referred to as the monomers. How can we classify these polymers? There are different criteria for classifying polymers. See, first is based on their source. We can classify polymers into three important categories, that is natural, synthetic and semi-synthetic. These are the three classes of polymers. We shall discuss in detail. What are these natural polymers? As the name indicates, these are polymers found in nature, that is in plants and animals. Examples are proteins, cellulose, starch, resins, rubber. These are natural polymers. What are the semi-synthetic? Semi means half, that is they are half synthetic. They are not completely synthetic. These are modifications of, they are synthetic modifications of natural polymers. Examples are cellulose acetate, usually called as rayon, cellulose nitrate. These are examples of semi-synthetic polymers. So, synthetic polymers are man-made polymers. They are completely artificial, they are man-made. Examples are polythene, nylon 66, Buna-S. These are some of the examples. Again, we can classify these polymers based on their structure. There are three different types. They are linear polymers, branched chain polymers and cross-linked polymers. What are they? See, what are these linear polymers? As the name indicates, they consist of long and straight chains. The polymeric chains are stacked or arranged over one another to give a well-packed structure. Thus, they have high densities and high tensile strength. Also, they have high melting points. See, examples are HDPE, that is high density polyethylene, PVC, that is polyvinyl chloride, nylons, polyesters. These are examples. Can see the diagram showing the linear polymer. So, these are the polymer chains, they are arranged linearly like this. Next is branched chain polymers. They contain linear chains having some branches. They are irregularly packed and thus have low density, lower tensile strength and lower melting points compared to linear polymers. Examples are LDPE, that is low density polyethylene, amylopectin, glycogen. These are examples. Let us see the diagram of this branched chain polymers. So, this is a main polymer chain and they contain branches like this. Next is cross-linked or network polymers. So, here the monomer units are linked together to constitute a three-dimensional network structure. They contain strong covalent bonds and these bonds are often called as cross-links between the various linear polymer chains. These are usually formed from bifunctional and trifunctional monomers. They are hard, rigid and brittle in nature. Examples are bakelite, melamin formaldehyde resin, etc. Here you can see the crosslinks like this. So, these are the main polymer chains and these are the crosslinks in between the polymer chains. Next is classification based on mode of polymerization. How this polymerization process occurs? Based on this, we can classify polymers into two broad categories, that is adhesion polymers and condensation polymers. The adhesion polymers can be further classified into homopolymers and copolymers. What are these adhesion polymers? So, these are formed by repeated adhesion of monomer molecules possessing double or triple bonds without the elimination of any byproduct molecules. Examples are polyethylene, polypropylene, PVC, orlon, PAN, that is polyacrylonitrile. These are examples. Homopolymers are adhesion polymers formed by the polymerization of a single monomeric species. Examples are polyethylene, polypropene, etc. Copolymers are made by adhesion polymerization from two different monomers. Examples are Buna S. It is formed by the reaction between 1,3-butadiene and styrene. Another example is Buna N. It is formed by the reaction between 1,3-butadiene and acrylonitrile. You can see the reaction here. So, it is 1,3-butadiene, it reacts with styrene to form butadiene styrene copolymer, which is called as Buna S. It is also known as SBR, that is styrene butadiene rubber. Next is 1,3-butadiene reacts with acrylonitrile to form Buna N. Next is condensation polymers. So, they are formed by repeated condensation reaction between two different bifunctional or trifunctional monomeric units. In these polymerization reactions, the elimination of small molecules such as water, alcohol or HCl takes place. Examples are nylon 6,6. It is formed by the reaction between hexamethylene, diamine and adipic acid. You can see the reaction. So, this is adipic acid, that is hexane 1,6-dioic acid. And this is hexamethylene diamine. They react at high pressure and 553 Kelvin to form nylon 6,6. Again, we can classify the polymers based on the molecular forces existing between the monomer units. There are four categories. They are elastomers, fibers, thermoplastic polymers and thermosetting plastics or polymers. What are these elastomers? So, these are rubber-like solids with elastic properties. The polymer chains are held together by weakest intermolecular forces, which permit the polymers to be stretched. And a few crosslinks are introduced in between the chains, which help the polymer to retract to its original position after the force is released. Examples are Buna S, then Buna N, neoprene. These are examples of elastomers. You can see some images showing elastomers here. So, next is the fibers. These are thread forming solids which possess high tensile strength and high modulus. They are strong, there are strong intermolecular forces like hydrogen bonding, which leads to close packing of the polymer chains and thus impart crystalline nature to these polymers. Examples are nylon 6,6, terylene, etc. You can see the image showing fibers. Next, we have thermoplastic polymers. These are linear or slightly branched long chain molecules capable of repeatedly softening on heating and hardening on cooling. They possess intermolecular forces of attraction intermediate between elastomers and fibers. Examples are polyethylene, polystyrene, polyvinyls, etc. Next is thermosetting polymers. These are cross-linked or heavily branched molecules which on heating undergo extensive crosslinks in molds and again become infusible. So, they cannot be reused again, they cannot be recycled. Examples are bakelite, urea formaldehyde resin. You can see the image showing some thermosetting polymers. Now, you can classify these polymers based on the growth of the polymer chain, that is how the polymerization occurs, how the polymer chain grows. There are two categories, chain growth polymers and step growth polymers. We shall discuss them in detail. So, this classification is based on the type of polymerization. There are two broad types of polymerization reactions. They are addition or chain growth polymerization and condensation or step growth polymerization. What is this addition polymerization? It is also known as chain growth polymerization. Here, the polymer molecules of the same monomer or different monomers add together on a large scale to form a polymer. The monomers are unsaturated compounds or their derivatives. It leads to an increase in chain length or chain growth can take place through the formation of either free radicals or ionic species. Based on this, we have two mechanisms of polymerization, that is free radical mechanism and the ionic mechanism. It can be cationic or anionic. What is this free radical mechanism? So, you might have studied about free radicals. These are highly reactive species containing unpaired electrons. So, polymerization of alkenes or dienes and their derivatives in presence of a free radical generating initiator, which acts as the catalyst, is known as free radical polymerization. Examples are polymerization of ethene to polyethene in presence of small amount of benzoyl peroxide initiator, which can produce free radicals. The free radical mechanism consists of three steps. They are chain initiation step, chain propagating step, and chain terminating step. In the chain initiation step, the radical formed from the peroxide adds to double bond of the monomer, thus generating a new and larger free radical. Let us see the reaction. So, this is the chain initiation step. This is benzoyl peroxide, which can generate free radicals. It generates a free radical like this, and then it changes to phenyl free radical, which adds to the monomer, that is ethylene, to form another free radical species. The second step is chain propagating step. Here, the larger radical formed in the initiation step reacts with the reactant molecule to form another bigger radical and carries the reaction forward. Hence, it is called chain propagation. Let us see the reaction. So, this is the free radical formed earlier. It further reacts with another monomer molecule to form yet another free radical entity, which then undergoes polymerization like this to form a large free radical species like this, and thus the reaction is propagated. The final step is chain termination. Termination means stopping. Here, the product radical formed reacts with another radical to form the polymerized product. So, that is the here the polymerization process stops, hence it is called a chain termination. The reaction is, so this is the free radical species formed. The two free radical species formed combine together to form a neutral species, which is a polymer. Next is preparation of some important polymers. First is polyethylene. So, it is an addition polymer because it is formed by the addition of ethylene molecules. There are two varieties of polyethylene, HDP, that is high density polyethylene, and LDP, that is low density polyethylene. The low density polyethylene is obtained by the polymerization of ethene under high pressure of 1000 to 2000 atmospheres and at a temperature of about 350 Kelvin to 570 Kelvin in that range, in the presence of dioxygen or a peroxide initiator which acts as the catalyst. It is formed by free radical addition and hydrogen abstraction, and this polymer has a highly branched structure. It is chemically inert. It is used in the insulation of electricity carrying wires and the manufacture of squeeze bottles, toys and flexible pipes. Let us see an image showing LDPE. The high density polyethylene, they are formed by when the addition of ethylene takes place in a hydrocarbon solvent in the presence of a catalyst such as triethyl aluminium and titanium tetrachloride, which is usually known as Ziegler-Natta catalyst, at a temperature of 333 Kelvin to 343 Kelvin and under a pressure of 6 to 7 atmospheres. It consists of linear molecules and has high density due to close packing. It is chemically inert. It is more tougher and harder. It is used for manufacturing buckets, dustbins, bottles, pipes, etc. We can see an image. Next is Teflon, which is polytetrafluoroethene. It is manufactured by heating tetrafluoroethene with a free radical or persulfate catalyst at high pressures. It is chemically inert, resistant to attack by corrosive reagents. Hence, it is used for making oil seals, gaskets, non-stick surface coated utensils, etc. So, the reaction is, this is tetrafluoroethene. It undergoes polymerization in presence of catalyst and under high pressure to form Teflon like this. Again, let us see an image showing Teflon. Next is polyacrylonitrile or PAN. It is formed by the addition polymerization of acrylonitrile, that is vinyl cyanide, in presence of a peroxide catalyst. It is used as a substitute for wool in making commercial fibers as Arlon or Acrylan. So, the reaction is, this is acrylonitrile. So, a large number of acrylonitrile molecules undergo polymerization in presence of peroxide catalyst to form polyacrylonitrile. We can see an image showing PAN. Next is condensation polymerization or step growth polymerization. It involves repetitive condensation reaction between two bifunctional monomers. It results in the loss of some simple molecules as water, alcohol, etc. It leads to the formation of high molecular mass condensation polymers. Since each step produces a distinct functional species and is independent of each other, this process is also called as step growth polymerization. Examples are formation of terylene or dacron by the interaction of ethylene glycol and terephthalic acid. We can see the reaction. So, this is ethylene glycol or ethane 1,2-diol. It reacts with terephthalic acid or benzene 1,4-dicarboxylic acid to form terylene or dacron. Next, we shall discuss some important condensation polymers. So, there are four categories of condensation polymers. They are polyamides, polyesters, phenol formaldehyde polymers, and melamine formaldehyde polymer. Let us see in detail. These polyamides are polymers possessing amide linkage. They are generally prepared by the condensation polymerization of diamines with dicarboxylic acids and also of amino acids and their lactams. Let us see the preparation of nylon 6,6, which is a very important polymer. It is prepared by the condensation polymerization of hexamethylene diamine with adipic acid under high pressure and high temperature, that is about 553 Kelvin. It is used in making sheets, bristles for brushes and in textile industry. Let us see an image showing nylon 6,6. Next is nylon 6. It is obtained by heating caprolactam with water at a high temperature. Caprolactam is a cyclic amide. It is used for, this nylon 6 is used for the manufacture of tire cords, fabrics and ropes. The reaction is, so this is caprolactam, I have already told you, it is a cyclic amide and it reacts at about 533 to 543 Kelvin to form nylon 6, polymerizes to form nylon 6. First an amino caproic acid is formed, it then polymerizes to form nylon 6. Let us see an image showing nylon 6. Next is polyesters. So, these are polycondensation products of dicarboxylic acids and diols. See, diols means they are dihydric alcohols, they contain two OH groups per structure. Now, these polymers contain ester linkage as shown below, hence they are called as polyesters. Next is pterylene, which is also known as Dacron. It is manufactured by heating a mixture of ethylene glycol and terephthalic acid at 420 Kelvin to 460 Kelvin in presence of zinc acetate and antimony trioxide catalyst. We have already seen the reaction. It is grease resistant and used for blending with cotton and wool fibers. It is also used as glass reinforcing materials and in safety helmets. Let us see an image. Next is phenol formaldehyde polymer, that is bakelite and related polymers. It is obtained by the condensation reaction of phenol with formaldehyde in the presence of either an acid or a base catalyst. Initially, ortho and or para hydroxy methyl phenol derivatives are formed, which further react with phenol to form compounds having rings joined to each other through CH2 groups. First, we will take Novolac. It is a linear polymer formed by the reaction of ortho and or para hydroxy methyl phenol derivatives with phenol. It is used in paints. Let us see the reaction. So, this is phenol, the CH2O is formaldehyde. In presence of acid or basic medium, it undergoes reaction to form these intermediates. So, there are ortho derivatives as well as para derivatives, a mixture is formed. Then it undergoes polymerization to form a linear chain like this. We can see an image showing Novolac. Next is bakelite. See, Novolac on heating with formaldehyde undergoes cross linking to form an infusible solid mass called bakelite. It is used for making combs, phonograph records, electrical switches and handles of various utensils. We can see the reaction. So, this is the CH2 crosslinks present in bakelite. It is a highly crosslinked polymer and is a hard polymer. You can also see an image showing different varieties of bakelite. Next is melamine formaldehyde polymer. It is formed by the condensation polymerization of melamine and formaldehyde. It is used in the manufacture of unbreakable crockery. We can see the reaction how this melamine formaldehyde polymer is formed. So, this is melamine. It reacts with formaldehyde to form a resin intermediate like this. It further undergoes polymerization to form melamine formaldehyde polymer like this. You can see an image. So, this melamine formaldehyde is used for manufacturing unbreakable crockery. Next is copolymerization. This is the polymerization reaction in which a mixture of more than one monomeric species is allowed to polymerize. It contains multiple units of each monomer used in the same polymeric chain. Copolymers have properties quite different from homopolymers. Example is a mixture of 1,3-butadiene and styrene can form a copolymer called Buna-S. Here, this Bu stands for butadiene, Na for natrium, that is sodium, which is the polymerizing agent, and S stands for styrene. It is quite tough and is a good substitute for natural rubber. It is used for the manufacture of auto tires, floor tiles, footwear components, cable insulation, etc. The reaction is, so this is 1,3-butadiene, it reacts with the styrene to form butadiene styrene copolymer, which is known as Buna-S. You can see an image showing Buna-S. Next is rubber. So, rubber has different varieties, that is natural rubber and synthetic rubbers. First, we will discuss natural rubber. It is a natural polymer. It possesses elastic properties. It is also termed as elastomer. It is manufactured from rubber latex, which is a colloidal dispersion of rubber in water. You can see an image. So, this is a rubber latex. It is obtained from the bark of rubber tree. And if you examine the structure, it consists of, it is a linear polymer of isoprene. Isoprene is 2-methyl-1,3-butadiene and is also called as cis-1,4-polyisoprene because it is a cis isomer. There is the trans isomer also, it is known as gutta-percha, but natural rubber is the cis isomer. We can see the structure. So, this is the structure of natural rubber. It is a cis isomer of isoprene, hence it is known as cis isoprene, cis polymer. Natural rubber consists of various chains held together by weak van der Waals interactions and has a coiled structure. Thus, it can be stretched like a spring. It becomes soft at high temperatures above 335 Kelvin and brittle at low temperatures, that is below 283 Kelvin. And it shows high water absorption capacity. It is soluble in nonpolar solvents and is non-resistant to attack by oxidizing agents. Next is vulcanization of rubber. It is an important process used for modifying the properties of natural rubber. In this process, it is a process to improve the physical properties of rubber. It consists of heating a mixture of raw rubber with sulfur and an appropriate additive at a temperature range between 373 to 415 Kelvin. On vulcanization, sulfur forms crosslinks at the reactive sites of double bonds and thus the rubber gets stiffened. In the manufacture of tire rubber, 5% of sulfur is used as a crosslinking agent. So, these are the crosslinks, that is sulfur crosslinks formed between the polymer chains. That is why rubber gets hardened as a result of vulcanization. Let us see an image related to vulcanization. So, this picture shows the formation of crosslinks. So, these are the sulfur crosslinks formed between the rubber molecules. This is another picture showing the formation of sulfur crosslinks. Next is a synthetic rubber. So, any vulcanizable rubber like polymer, which is capable of getting stretched to twice its length, are often called as synthetic rubbers. It returns to its original shape and size as soon as the external stretching force is released. These are not natural forms, they are artificially prepared varieties of rubber. So, neoprene is an important synthetic polymer. It is polychloroprene. It is formed by the free radical polymerization of chloroprene. So, chloroprene is the monomer. It has superior resistance to vegetable and mineral oils. Hence, it is used for manufacturing conveyor belts, gaskets and hoses. You can see the reaction. So, this is chloroprene, which is 2-chloro-1,3-butadiene. It undergoes polymerization to form neoprene, or which is known as polychloroprene. You can also see an image related to neoprene. Next is buna-N. It is obtained by the copolymerization of 1,3-butadiene and acrylonitrile in the presence of a peroxide catalyst. It is resistant to the action of petrol, lubricating oil and organic solvents. Hence, it is used in making oil seals, tank lining, etc. You can see the reaction. So, this is 1,3-butadiene. This is acrylonitrile, which is vinyl cyanide. It undergoes copolymerization to form buna-N. We can see an image. So, these are different oil seals and these are gaskets made of buna-N. Next is about molecular mass of polymers. We have already told you that polymers are macromolecules. That means they contain a large number of monomer units. So, usually they are having very high molecular mass. The polymer properties are closely related to their molecular mass, size and structure. The growth of the polymer chain during the synthesis is dependent upon the availability of the monomers in the reaction mixture. Thus, the polymer sample contains chains of varying lengths and hence its molecular mass is always expressed as an average. We usually express the molecular mass in two ways, that is number average molecular mass and mass average molecular mass. So, what are the adverse effects of polymers? A large number of polymers are quite resistant to the environmental degradation process and are thus responsible for accumulation of polymeric solid waste materials, which cause acute environmental problems and remain undegraded for quite a long time. So, these cause a lot of environmental problems. So, here comes the importance of biodegradable polymers. These are new biodegradable synthetic polymers, which contain functional groups similar to the functional groups present in biopolymers like proteins, carbohydrates, etc. These polymers can be broken into small segments by enzyme catalyzed reactions. Hence, they are called as biodegradable. Examples are PHBV, nylon-2, nylon-6 are some examples. We can see an image related to biodegradable polymers. So, they can undergo degradation like this. This image shows the degradation process of a biodegradable polymer. So, what is this PHBV? It is poly beta hydroxy butyrate co beta hydroxy valerate. Thus, it is a copolymer. It is obtained by the copolymerization of 3-hydroxybutanoic acid and 3-hydroxypentanoic acid. It is used in specialty packaging, orthopedic devices, and in controlled release of drugs. It undergoes bacterial degradation in the environment. So, the reaction is, so this is the reaction showing the formation of PHBV. It is 3-hydroxybutanoic acid. This is 3-hydroxypentanoic acid. They undergo condensation to form PHBV. Let us see an image showing PHBV. So, these are different articles made of this biodegradable polymer PHBV. Next is nylon-2, nylon-6. It is again a copolymer. See, alternating polyamide copolymer of glycine and aminocaproic acid is known as nylon-2, nylon-6. We can see the reaction showing the formation of this polymer. So, this is glycine, which is a amino acid, and it reacts with aminocaproic acid, undergoes condensation between this COH group and NS2 group to form nylon-2, nylon-6. So, these are some important polymers of commercial importance. Polyethylene or polythene, monomer is ethylene. It is used as an insulator and packing material. Then polypropene is obtained by the polymerization of propene. It is used in the manufacture of ropes, toys, pipes, etc. Next is polystyrene, which is also known as styron, obtained by the polymerization of styrene. It is also used as an insulator and wrapping material. Next is PVC, which is otherwise known as coroseal. It is obtained by the polymerization of vinyl chloride. It is used in the manufacture of raincoats, handbags, etc. Next is urea formaldehyde resin. It is obtained by the polymerization of urea and formaldehyde. It is used for making unbreakable cups and laminated sheets. And glyptal is obtained by the polymerization of ethylene glycol and phthalic acid. It is used in the manufacture of paints and lacquers. Bakelite we have already discussed, obtained by the polymerization of phenol and formaldehyde. It is used for making combs, electrical switches, etc. Next is nylon 6. So, it is obtained by the polymerization of caprolactam. It is used in making fibers, plastic, tire cords and ropes. Next is nylon 6,6. It is obtained by the polymerization of hexamethylene diamine and adipic acid, used in the manufacture of carpets, ropes and belts. Next is nylon 2, nylon 6. We already discussed it is a biodegradable polymer formed from glycine and aminocaproic acid. Then Teflon is tetrafluoro, it is polytetrafluoroethylene. It is obtained by the polymerization of tetrafluoroethylene. It is used in insulation as a lubricant and for covering this cooking wares, etc. Next is Buna-N. It is obtained by the polymerization of vinyl cyanide. It is used in oil seals, hoses, etc. Next is neoprene. It is obtained by the polymerization of chloroprene, used in conveyor belts and insulators. Next is terylene or dacron. It is obtained by the polymerization of ethylene glycol and terephthalic acid. It is also used in tire cords and fibers. Next is orlon or acrylan. It is obtained by the polymerization of acrylonitrile. It is used as wool-like fibers for suits, then and sweaters, bathing suits, etc. Urea formaldehyde resin we have already discussed. Next is melmac. It is obtained by the polymerization of melamine and formaldehyde. It is used in unbreakable crockery. Now let us discuss some sample questions based on polymers. First question is, which of the following is a natural polymer? Options are glyptal, nylon 6, starch, polyester, terylene. So, here starch is a natural polymer, hence the correct option is C. Next question, which of the following is a linear polymer? Options, bakelite, PVC, alkyd resin, melamine formaldehyde resin, low density polyethylene. PVC is a linear polymer, but bakelite, alkyd resin and melamine formaldehyde resins are highly cross linked polymers. LDPE is a branched chain polymer. So, here the correct answer is option B, that is PVC, which is polyvinyl chloride. Next question, if a polymer becomes more crystalline, options are it becomes harder, it becomes denser, it becomes more resistant to heat, it becomes harder, denser and resistant to heat, it becomes neither harder nor denser but becomes resistant to heat. Crystalline polymers are harder, denser and resistant to heat. Therefore, the correct answer here is option D. Next question, which of the following is not an example of an addition polymer? Options, polyethylene, polystyrene, PVC, polypropylene and dacron. Dacron or terylene is a condensation polymer of ethylene glycol and terephthalic acid. Hence, the correct answer here is option E, because it is not an addition polymer, it is a condensation polymer. All others are addition polymers. Next question, which of the following is an elastomer? Options are neoprene, terylene, polystyrene, urea formaldehyde resin, bakelite. Neoprene is a rubber like solid with elastic properties. Therefore, the correct answer here is option A, that is neoprene. Others are not elastomers. Next question is, amongst the following, the branched chain polymer is, options are polyester, PVC, low density polyethylene, nylon 6,6 and polypropylene. low density polyethylene, which is obtained through the free radical addition and hydrogen abstraction, has a highly branched structure. Therefore, here the correct option is C, that is LDP. It is only the branched chain polymer, all others are linear polymers. Next question, which of the following properties is true for thermoplastics? Options: the intermolecular forces of attraction are intermediate between elastomers and fibers, they have cross linking between them, they cannot be molded by heating, they are rubber like solids with elastic properties, they are thread forming solids with which possess high tensile strength. Thermoplastic possess intermolecular forces of attraction intermediate between elastomers and fibers. Therefore, the correct option is A. Next question, which of the following is a homopolymer? Options are Buna-S, Buna-N, Bakelite, Nylon 66 and polythene. Polythene is a homopolymer since it contains a single monomeric species, that is ethene or ethylene. Therefore, the correct answer is E, option E, that is polythene. Others are not homopolymers. Next question, a copolymer of 1,3-butadiene and styrene is called. Options: Novolac, Buna-S, Buna-N, neoprene and polystyrene. Buna-S is formed by the addition polymerization of 1,3-butadiene and styrene. Therefore, the correct option here is B, that is Buna-S. Next question, which of the following is a condensation polymer? Options are polystyrene, Buna-S, Buna-N, nylon 66 and polythene. Nylon 66 is formed by the condensation of hexamethylene diamine and adipic acid. Therefore, the correct option is nylon 66, it is a condensation polymer. Next question, which of the following is or are true for thermosetting polymers? They are cross-linked or heavily branched molecules, they undergo extensive cross-linking on heating, their hardening is irreversible, they cannot be reused, all the above are correct options. So, all these are characteristics of thermosetting polymers, therefore, the correct option is E, that is all the above are characteristics of thermosetting polymers. Next question, among the following, the weakest interparticle forces of attraction are present in fibers, elastomers, thermosetting polymers, thermoplastic polymers, polyamides. Elastomers have the weakest intermolecular forces of attraction between the polymer chains. Therefore, the correct option is B, that is elastomers. Which cannot form addition polymers? The options are CH2 double bond CH2 and COH CH2 4 times COH, then C6H5 CH double bond CH2, next is CH2 double bond CHCN, CH3 CH double bond CH2. See, adipic acid is a bifunctional monomer and hence it can take part in condensation polymerization only. Therefore, the correct answer is option B, because this is adipic acid, it contains two COH groups, hence it can take part in condensation polymerization. Next question, the catalyst used for the manufacture of LDP, that is low density polyethylene, is A, trimethyl aluminium and titanium tetrachloride, sodium and ethanol, iron, hydrogen in presence of nickel, vanadium pentoxide. Trimethyl aluminium and titanium tetrachloride, which is known as Ziegler-Natta catalyst, it is used for the manufacture of LDP. Therefore, the correct option is A. Next question, natural rubber is polyvinyl chloride, trans polyisoprene, cis polyisoprene, polychloroprene, polyacrylonitrile. We have already discussed that natural rubber is a linear polymer of cis-1,4 polyisoprene. Therefore, the correct answer is cis polyisoprene. The option is C. Next question. Which of the following polymers have more than one type of monomers? Nylon 6, nylon 66, Teflon, Bunias, and the options are 1 and 2, 2 and 3, 1 and 4, 1 and 3, 2 and 4. So, here the correct option is nylon 66 and Bunias. So, both have two monomers. Therefore, the correct option is E, that is 2 and 4. Next question. The polymer Melmac is formed by options: condensation polymerization of melamine and formaldehyde, addition polymerization of melamine and formaldehyde, coordination polymerization of melamine, coordination polymerization of formaldehyde, free radical polymerization of tetrafluoroethylene. Melamine formaldehyde polymer is formed by the condensation polymerization of melamine and formaldehyde. Therefore, the correct option is A. Next question. Bunion is a copolymer of options: styrene and formaldehyde, formaldehyde and acrylonitrile, 1,3-butadiene and styrene, 1,3-butadiene and acrylonitrile, 1,3-butadiene and chloroprene. Bunion is a copolymer of 1,3-butadiene and acrylonitrile. Therefore, the correct answer is option D. Next question. In vulcanization of rubber, options are: sulfur reacts to form a new compound, sulfur crosslinks are introduced, sulfur forms a very thin protective layer over rubber, sulfur breaks the polyisoprene chain. All the statements are correct. On vulcanization, sulfur forms crosslinks at the reactive sites of double bonds of the polyisoprene chain, and thus rubber gets stiffened. Therefore, the correct answer is B, that is sulfur crosslinks are introduced. So, the last question is, the biodegradable polymer among the following is nylon 6, nylon 66, nylon 6, nylon 66, then nylon 2, nylon 6, nylon 6, nylon 610. Nylon 2, nylon 6 is a biodegradable polymer formed by the copolymerization of glycine and aminocaproic acid. Therefore, the correct answer here is option D, that is nylon 2, nylon 6. So, we have discussed the important aspects of polymers and some sample questions. You have to read the NCERT test book thoroughly and prepare similar questions. It will be really helpful for you. Thank you.